All right, it appears we are ready for our K2 Mania run, so take it away, Tom and Ryu.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah, I'm Tom. I'll be showcasing K2 Mania, or, you know, we'll talk about the game later, but yeah, very excited to showcase this very fun game. And on commentary, I have Ryu.
Hello. I was just here on a different rhythm game, so I'll be using my expertise there.
Cool. Yeah, with that, I think we're just ready to get started. So, I'll count us down. 3, 2, 1, go!
All right, so we are now getting into our K-Shoot Mania showcase. So for anyone who's familiar with Sound Voltex, which is what Tom alluded to just now, it is a fan-made clone, similar to how Clone Hero and Guitar Hero. So you have all the communities making their custom charts for this. For those not familiar with K-Shoot Mania or Sound Voltex, so what you see on the screen is going to be a vertical scrolling rhythm game, and you're going to have three main elements. So you have the white notes, which you can see on Tom's hand cam. Those are the four white notes in a line, and then you have orange. There's two orange buttons beneath, and they always take a path of track. And then you have these blue and pink tracks that run along the sides and cross over. Those are going to be controlled by the knobs on the right and left side of the controller. Those are a little bit deceptive. You don't have to follow them perfectly. You just have to be turning the knob in the correct direction. If it's going to the right, then you want to be turning the knob clockwise and vice versa. So the difficulty, you can see on the top left hand side is level 12 underneath the name of the song. So that's the difficulty that the game assigns. So those range from 1 to 20. But most people, especially if you have a little bit of rhythm game experience, most people can probably start around a 5 to 10. For example, I first played Sound Voltex last year at SGDQ and was starting out around like a 6 and 7. So that was our first track, Bad Apple. That was one of the lowest difficulties that we're going to have on here. That was only a 12, and we're going to immediately get right into some of the harder tracks. We're starting at a 17, and we're going to see up to 20, the max difficulty. So let's get into it. This is Infinity Overdrive. So something that you'll notice while watching the hand cam is that the hand movements are really important in this game. The hand positioning, being able to cross one of your hands over to the other side of the controller while still playing the middle notes with the other hand, very important. You're going to start seeing this showcase more and more since you're now getting into the higher difficulties. And difficulty 17, which is what we're on right now, is one of the biggest walls of skill. Like each jump in level or difficulty is pretty significant, but at 17 it's pretty infamously hard to start adapting to the faster patterns, the more complex hand switching and everything like that. But a lot of this is just going to be enjoying the show, man. Like, Tom is one of the most talented rhythm game players I've ever seen. Every single rhythm game he touches, he's just amazing at pretty much immediately. This is definitely well beyond my own skill, so I'm just watching here like the rest of y'all. Another thing to take note, at the bottom of the gameplay screen, you can see a lot of, almost all of them say critical, but it's it's also giving off a yellow color, so that's actually going to indicate the accuracy of the note hit. You're going to get yellow for a perfect hit, and then I believe it goes green and then pink, or near and then miss. Alright, on to our third track. This is Lethaeus, Silent Rune, another 17. This one is definitely a harder 17 than the previous one, mostly due to the fact that there's a lot of one-handed movement in this track where you have one of these knobs, one of these pots moving, so you need to have a hand on the knob, which means everything else while that's happening has to be done with the other hand by itself. So you're sometimes playing all six of the other buttons with just one hand, so it gets really difficult. Not only that, this song has a lot of different rhythm choices, and as we get into the more complex songs, like, you're going to hear some pretty difficult rhythms, and you really got to try to match it, which is difficult, especially on this scroll speed. So another thing of note, Tarkan is a player in his vertical scrolling rhythm game experience. He plays on crazy low scroll speed. Like, it is much harder to read when you can see, like, 15 notes ahead of what you need to do, because you need to be watching what's coming, and it's much easier to do that when there's not as many notes on the screen. So even if some of you have some experience with vertical scroller rhythm games, you might be having some pretty huge difficulty reading something like what we're seeing right now, or some later ones where, yeah, Tom really is just a master of reading complex patterns with ease.
Do I have time to step in?
Oh yeah, sure.
Alright, I just want to reiterate that by the end of this run, we need to see that $200 met for the 20 Gauntlet Encore. Right now we're at 17, and I mean, Tom's kind of doing a little too well on this. I need to see him struggle. So I need to see those 20s. We only need $64 for that to be met. Needs it by the end of the run. We also have the milestone, of course. Any donation towards the incentive goes towards a milestone. Still a long ways away there, guys. We need $650. I know we can do it. We just need to push during these last two couple runs. So, let's get it done.
Yeah, I, for one, would absolutely love to see the 20 difficulty showcase. I've seen some of the charts. They are incredible. They are insane. And Palm just goes crazy on them. So I would really, really love if we can get some more donations in for that. So we get into our first 18. Although, I think Tom would agree with me that Lethaeus, the last chart, is pretty much it's definitely one of the harder 17s, where you would probably count it as this is not really a real 17. This is more like an 18 or a 19, that kind of thing. But yeah, the difficulty is definitely going to start ramping up. And Tom did, was saying earlier that this 18 is easier for him, than a lot of 17s. I know I reiterated that, the jump in difficulty between each number is pretty significant, but depending on exactly what you like to play and what you're good at, you're gonna find some things gonna be easier than others, that doesn't match up to its, you know, objective difficulty. And now we get this really crazy dreaming pattern. That's where a lot of expertise in other rhythm games really comes in clutch, where you don't have these knobs to deal with. You're just doing rapid fire stairs and streams and jacks and jumps and all these things. There's a lot of terms for what we call patterns, but they're pretty descriptive. Like, a stream is a stream of notes. Stairs, you know, they're going in one slope without jumping to another one. You kind of just roll your hands in order. All right, Crepe Suzette, Kamamasano. This one's got some really tricky rhythms. This is actually one of my suggestions. Tom said what needed some additions, and we went through a bunch of charts together, kind of pick out which ones were good. This is one of my suggestions. I really like this artist that I found from playing OSU. And this section is just brutal. Brutal with the knobs and the switching. Yeah, his hands are just going crazy, just going right back and forth all the time. Oh, something I didn't mention about these knobs, the blue and pink pads, you see them go perpendicular to the track, like those. You don't actually have to match the velocity of that, which would be impossible because it would travel across horizontally like instantly. You just have to be moving the knob in the same direction, similar to how you play the other paths. That just kind of curve around. You just can follow those by doing a similar thing, but the perpendicular one.
Do we have some time for donations?
Oh yeah, keep them coming in. I wanna get to this showcase.
All right, we have $15 from A Witch Is Familiar that says, "Here's my going overtime tax." Thank you. We have $25 from Truffles. Thanks to everyone working behind the scenes to make ArchieCon happen. Long live Archie. And then we have $100 from Comet that simply says, "Whoa." Thank you, Comet.
Whoa. Wise Whoa. Words. Oh, and we were just so close to the 9.9 million, which is where the triple A becomes an S. Just going over the score system, around 9.7-ish, you're going to get the A, triple A, and then about 9.9 will be for the S, and then 1 million would be for a perfect. That's the max score you can get. Alright, so Take, or however you want to call it, is a really, really wacky song. I also know this one from playing OSU, and the part in OSU is just as wacky.
I absolutely love this song in any rhythm game it's in.
Oh yeah, for sure. It goes crazy. So you have this section where it's slow, and then as soon as you switch colors, it gets faster. Every single time. Faster again. There again. And it just keeps going. And like the time signatures are crazy, the rhythms are insane, and it gets insanely fast at the end. We're going to see another example of Tom playing on very low scroll speed on this map because the ending BPM of this song is like 300 something, I want to say, which is just absurdly high. And it's just going to be extremely dense because, I mean, even in this section, you can see like 30 notes ahead. Like all these rhythm changes, like you go from like triplets to quarter notes, and like, god, it is just a crazy mess. And we're getting to the ending here, just gotta sit back and enjoy. Oh my god. Oh man, I love that. Alright, and we are moving on to our first 19. This is Daisy Cutter. Despite not being the max difficulty of 20, this is still one of the most trickiest, yeah, English, parts in the game. There's a lot of crossovers, while you're using both of the knobs with one hand, switching them over, or it's going to be the one-handed gameplay that I mentioned earlier. The one hand is on the knobs going back and forth, and the other hand is just doing everything by itself on the middle. Actually, something that you can probably notice in this chart especially is that the blue and pink knobs actually emulate like the bass and treble knob on like a soundboard. So you, when you turn one, it turns the treble or the bass of that song like up or down. It's hard to tell when they're both going, but when you only have one of the knobs going, it's really cool. That's one of the only sound effects on the game. Like these, the orange buttons, when you hold them, they also do a little bit of a sound effect on the song. It's like its own custom hit sounds instead of just having the normal ones when you tap.
Do we have some time for some incentives?
Oh yeah.
Alright. What I forgot to mention, and I apologize, is that with that $100 from Comet, we have met the 20 Gauntlet Encore, so we get to see Tom struggle.
Let's go!
Very exciting. And I would like to announce that we have a new incentive. We have the VVVVV run coming up, and at the end of that, if we get $125, we will see a bonus Big Viridian run. If met, Uni will do a bonus run with a glitch that causes the protagonist to get a super large hitbox, breaking the game and allowing for the run to be completed in just 5 minutes. I love these super broken runs. I need to see them. $125. Let's get it there.
Absolutely. We've had a number of glitch exhibitions in this event in past years, so I would love to see another one. Those are always so cool. Alright, so we're getting into our next 19 here. This is Tempestissimo by T-Paz, one of the most prolific rhythm game artists out there. And this one is just crazy. You're just gonna have to watch the hand cam because there is some absolutely wild things that Tom is about to do. This song is also one of the fastest, highest BPM songs on the setlist, not counting Take, which is kind of a variable BPM, but 231 is ridiculous. And you can just see that showcased right there. And here we go! That ending is just brutal. And it's not even over. Nice. Okay, so Goodbye Merry-Go-Round by You, another pretty well-known rhythm game artist. This is another 19, and the insanity has only just begun. We are going to just see more and more absolutely crazy charts. It just keeps ramping up. And since we hit that incentive, which I'm super hyped about, we're just going to keep the content going. This chart is definitely one of the more special ones on this set list. The ending is really interesting. You're just going to have to wait and see what's in store for us. But nothing too conventional there. It's pretty unorthodox. Have actually split. I don't remember. Oh, okay, here we go. The lanes literally swap sides. That's insane for me. I can't even comprehend that.
I feel like that would just fry my brain trying to do that.
Right? But nevertheless, another great score from Tom. Just below that S rank threshold. Okay, so this is our first difficulty 20. It's not going to be as crazy as what we're about to see in just a few minutes. But, this is where the 20 difficulty starts.
Such an immediate ramp up in difficulty. I thought 19 was bad.
Yeah, I mean, this one is mostly mechanics because there's not too much like weird stuff going on in the song or in the chart. So this is going to be one of the more vanilla 20s. It's just simply difficult. I mean, look at this. Oh, something that's worth mentioning is that the accuracy that you have in the map or in the chart doesn't actually show up anywhere besides if you're keeping track of the colors at the bottom, if you see yellows or greens or pinks. And most rhythm games is going to display your accuracy while you're playing. But this one you can only really keep track of if you're watching carefully for the colors at the bottom or if you're, I guess, looking at your score. Knowing like how much score you can have at any given point. Got some nice switching there. Got some back. And a nice long little stream, and there we go. That's a 20 for you. another really, that's another really, really fast song, 236 BPM. So that's definitely going to be a bit of a theme with these higher difficulties. When you have a higher BPM, obviously you can fit more complex stuff in a shorter amount of time. And as we're getting into our second 20, this is I, as the whole song title. This is actually a decent time if you want to throw in a donation while we ramp up this chart.
Alright, well, I do want to remind people, while it might seem far away, that a bonus Big Viridian run is coming up sooner than you might think. You only have about 30 minutes for the end of this K-Shoot Mania, and then 20 minutes for the VVV run, so we need $123 to get that done. Get extra gaming on ArtsyFon Day 1. Everyone wants extra gaming.
Oh, absolutely.
Who doesn't want to extend an event a little bit more, even if it's just, you know, 5-10 minutes? It's all you need. Every donation that goes towards that, again, goes towards our milestone, and with Math Hacker matching our donations up until all we need is $1,650 to see that Archie collab task get even more content, more than just 5 minutes. We get an entire task. We get Celeste. It's Celeste community. We need to see Celeste, right? So let's get it done.
And here we go. This laser section is just bonkers. It goes symmetrical and then asymmetrical, like just on the turn of a hat. If that's the right idiom. And you have the hand switching while you're, oh my. Very nice. Yeah, seeing these crazy complex patterns is only going to get more and more common from here. We've got two more tracks in this main set list, and then we've got four more for the incentive. All right. So we've got our first Camellia track here. Obviously, we have to have Camellia in a rhythm game showcase. This is one of the Camellia tracks or songs that I don't actually know very well, so I'm gonna be very confused. Okay, with all like the BPM changes and the rhythm choices and complexity, All right, so we just had a little bit of SV, which is scroll velocity, I believe. And that's the scroll speed just changes. It adds to the experience of the map, but it's definitely really hard to play. I have no idea what's going on.
I feel like sight reading something that changes your scroll speed would be a nightmare.
Yeah.
I can imagine that.
Oh yeah. I mean, I know there are people who can do that, but I mean that's a very, very advanced skill. But yeah, because it like subverts your reading experience. Like you get to the point where you're like, okay, I see this pattern coming towards me. I know exactly what to do. But then it just completely throws that out the window, and you have to react on the fly. All right, as we go over the 8 million mark, we are going to be getting into the end of this track. It's gonna get crazy, all these SV changes. Oh, those stops and starts are crazy. Wow. Uh, Okay, and the finale track of our main set list. This is Ragnarok, Graham and Camellia collab, an absolute banger. This is going to be a crazy, crazy track. One of the, definitely one of the more difficult tracks out of all of these. It's last of this section because it's just an absolutely epic song. And Tom is a huge Graham fan, so he obviously had to put one of these in. This is definitely a longer song than the rest of these, so if there are any other donations in right now, now would be a good time before we get into the meat of this map.
Alright, well, we have $10 from Toolot that says, rhythm games are cool, so is Archie collab. Thank you, Math, and long live Archie.
Yes. Long live Archie.
Reminder to everyone, every donation that comes in is getting matched until we would hit that cap of $2,000 for the Archie collab task by Math Hacker. So all it says 2,000. It's a lie. They're lying to you. It's only $16,050. $16,000. $1,650 for us to hit that Archie collab task, get Celeste on Celeste community. It's in reach. I see $200 left to get there. We can do it, guys.
We absolutely can. And Tom can absolutely play this insane track that's only going to get even more crazy. I mean, we have only reached 3 million. There's still, two-thirds of the map left? I keep saying map, I'm sorry. Or... Oh, the hand switching on this one is wild. Second half of this is a long one. It's a marathon. A lot of these charts don't have this problem, but once you get into these longer charts and high in difficulty as well, then your hand stamina actually really matters. Being able to just keep going for just like hundreds of notes. Into the last third. It's gonna get crazy. Those are so cool. The way that you have to place your hands to play those, alternating orange and white, like you switch your hands back and forth, like vertically instead of horizontally. I really like those. It just keeps going. Oh my god, this is brutal.
Alright. Yeah, so that's the end of the main set list. Well, I heard we, met the incentive. Oh, hell yeah.
And there we have it. That's Ragnarok.
Alright. Oh, man.
Good luck.
Alright, let's go.
New record.
I think I'm good now.
Cool. That's actually insane. Right in. Oh, yes, we did.
We are fortunate enough to get some more K-Shoot Mania gameplay. And hurt your hands just a little bit more.
Yeah, do you need a like a minute or two for a handbrake or something? Alright. Let's get into it. Alright, so these first three charts out of the four that we're about to see, all these are going to be 20s, as mentioned, but these first three are actually going to be from the official tournaments that contains the three biggest arcade rhythm games. It's King of Performai is the tournament, and the three rhythm games that are played there are Ongeki, Chunithem, and Mai Mai. Some of you may have heard of some of those, or all of them. But a lot of the rhythm game songs are actually coming from from games like that, or Sound Vortex. And these first three tracks are from that tournament. That is the tiebreakers. And the way that tiebreakers work in KOP is neither player has seen the track before. It is a customly made track just for that tournament, and this is one of them. You just have to jump right into this. Obviously, Tom did get to play this beforehand. I'm not really sure how he would do on this sight read, but you can just imagine how difficult that is in a tournament setting with the win on the line, and you just have to play this. Although, to be fair, this is one of the more simple difficulty 20s. You're not going to have as many complex laser patterns, you're not going to have the most, unplayable hand switching and one-handed gameplay. It's still obviously going to be difficult, it's well beyond anything that I could ever dream of playing, but from a more experienced perspective, this is going to be a little more simple. Another last detail about this one is this is from Mai Mai, the tiebreaker from Mai Mai, which is the washing machine rhythm game, if you've seen that before. Now that is, this ending is really mechanically intensive.
A lot of sevens. I think K-Shoot Media's like rating system is slightly different from Sound
Vortex's. Yeah, so with these incentive tracks, we're definitely seeing a little more of a struggle on some of these. That's a double A, which I don't think we've gotten any of those yet. I think we've been all triple A.
Would have been a triple A in normal Sound Vortex.
Oh, okay. Alright, so last track was Mai Mai Tiebreaker. This is going to be Ongeki Tiebreaker, and this is by Chroma, another well-known artist. This is going to feature a lot of crossing over of the hands. Well, I'm sure that you've all become pretty familiar with Tom's hands going wild over the controller.
Do we have time for some donos as Tom flies his hands around?
Oh yeah, absolutely.
Alright, we have $10 from Savadra that says, Tom and Ryu, my goats. I agree. We have $30 from Chuckles that says, V in Roman numerals is 5, so here's $30 for VVVVVV. Or is it called 555555? I don't know about that. We need a fact check.
That's a good question.
I might start calling it 555. And then we have $5 from Talia that says Boatring. A little $5 Boatring to get us to that Archie collab task. Can we get a Boatring going, gamers? I think we can, and we just need to push a little more. You only have about 10 minutes at the end of this K-Shoot Mania run, and then $20 minutes at the end of the VVV run to see that Archie collab task. We need to hit 1650. We can get there, gamers. Maybe a little Boa train will help us out.
I've got my Boa ready to go as soon as this is over.
I could participate in a little Boa action.
Oh yeah.
A little self-indulging Boa.
Oh, the one-handed part of this is insane. It still doesn't even make any sense to me how you play some of those patterns with one hand. Alright, do not be deceived. We're coming back. I legitimately don't even know what's going on the left and right side in that last pattern. Okay. I gotta say, that ending of that track was pretty blah. And there's another PV. Good job.
Oh boy.
Alright, number 3. So we had a Mai Mai tiebreaker, we had an Ongeki, and here we go with the Chunithem tiebreaker. This is going to be by Cosmo. And we are playing a 280 BPM map with a lot of mechanics. It's going to be extremely fast. After this little quiet section, of course. And of course, it wouldn't be a 20 without at least some complex lasering, so we're gonna get a bunch of those. Oh my god, that pattern is ridiculous. With all the oranges mixed in. Nice Jax. Not Elm Jax, though. Yeah, so... input overload. just cannot understand what's going on. Oh, and then we have 280 BPM jump streams. And then we've got one more drop. Yeah, more of an ending. That is a tough one. Well, you all wanted to see Tom struggle, so you get what you want, or what you wished for in that last one, and in this one. This is going to be our last track of our incentive set list. So we had those three tiebreakers from three different rhythm games, and this one is also from a rhythm game tiebreaker, but this one is from Osu, specifically Osu Mania, which is the vertical scrolling version of the game. So basically it's just this middle track without any of the knobs or lasers.
Can I hop in for some donos at the start of this?
Of course.
All right, I see a little bit of a boa train forming. We've got, of course, Comet's Boa, Talia's Boa, Bree with $5 with a Boa. I may have snuck my own $5 Boa in there. We need to see this VVV extra game, guys. We only have, what, one? This is the last song, right? One more song.
Oh, yeah.
And
this is the last one.
Small break and then the V run, 20 minutes. That's a cutoff. You guys got to get to 1650. I need just a little bit more Boa train. Can we get just a little bit more Boa?
I better see those Boas flooding in as we're getting through the first section of Parallel Universe Shifter. So this is another Camellia track. This was the tiebreaker of Grand Finals from 2023, last year, of the Mania World Cup. This is a long one. This is going to be a marathon, so we'll definitely have time for maybe a couple more donos. This is over 7 minutes long.
Jeez, okay. Well, I have noticed, and it's been there for a bit, but we have hit $1,500 on the day. Congrats
Ooh-hoo!
To everyone. But, of course, we're not done yet. We need to hit $1,650. $138, that's how much I see we need left. Let's get there, gamers. Just a little more Boa train, a little more anything, any last stretches just for the day. Get to 1650. Math Hacker will finish out the rest. Come in clutch, but we need to get there first.
This track is just an absolute gauntlet. There is pretty much everything you can think of in terms of gameplay style and track making decisions. There's just, you need to be able to do pretty much everything in the game to be able to play this one. The scroll speed is getting higher, the notes are coming faster, it's just getting more and more intense, and we're not even halfway through. So there's going to be a little bit of a funny coming up soon once we get out of this first half. So as we had with that earlier track, Take, The ending is going to speed up significantly. So right here during this break, Tom is going to turn that scroll speed way down. We're down at 0.7, and the notes are just going to crawl because it just gets way too fast at the end. We just need to be able to read the notes that Tom does. We don't need to be able to read them. I sure as hell can't. So you can actually just change it while you're still playing. But obviously, Tom did that during a break where he didn't have to be clicking any notes. But we're definitely going to see why this is necessary. It might not make too much sense to us, but it is going to get crazy as we keep on building. The BPM is going to keep rising, and we are going to get into some absolutely brutal sections.
Jump in real quick. We have $5 from Chuckles that simply says "Bwah." Keep the Bwah train going, gamers.
Keep them coming. Every Bwah is a giant step for Archie kind.
You might say one small Bwah for mankind.
Oh, yeah. I knew I got that quote wrong.
Don't worry, I think I did too as well.
Yeah, no, I didn't, can't even recognize where he went wrong. Alright, so it's at 250 BPM right now, you can see in the top left, but with the scroll speed, like, the notes are just so dense, the patterns are, you can pretty much see the next, like, 5 patterns, and I just gotta watch. I just gotta sit back and watch this. Oh, look at that BPM go up every single second. And here we go. This is why we had to lower that scroll speed. And there we go. That is K-Shoot Mania. GG, Tom.
BG.
Man, I'm tired.
No kidding.
Oh, man.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, that was time.
Yeah.
I forgot to preempt that.
Yeah, so hopefully you enjoyed. K-Shoot Mania, thankfully, is free to play. The controller is a bit expensive, but this is playable on keyboard, in fact. So yeah, if if this looks like fun to you, well, you know, I don't know, maybe it looks like pain to you, but if it looks like fun to you, yeah, it's a free download, it's a lot of fun. I've been playing for about a year now, and I've only enjoyed it, so, yeah.
And if you're one of the few lucky ones that has an arcade nearby with Sound Toltec, then that is also an option.
Yeah, for sure. There's a lot of, so in the US at least, there's round one where you can go, and like a lot of local arcades will have it as well. So yeah, this game is pretty available widely. But yeah. Outside of that, you know, thank you to Archie-Thon for letting me showcase this great game. And thanks to Ryu for doing a great job on commentary.
Thank you for inviting me.
Cool. It's all from me then.
All right, well, thank you. That was an incredible showcase. from Tom, and thank you to Ryu for being on comms as well.